The first thing you have to do is delete the cube and add two planes. Add a different material for each plane. Rename to arrange and connect the texture you found in each one. I use in each plane a random texture from internet. I increase the strength of light in the world shader for better visualization. To add these three nodes, you need to have the node Ringler add-on activated and press Ctrl T. As you can see when I scale the texture, this is not a seamless texture. Let's fix this, and inside Blender. To start, we have to add two array modifiers, one for X and the other for Y. With Ctrl L, you can copy the modifiers to the other plane. Go to the texture paint panel and use the clone tool. Ctrl and left mouse click to mark the cloning source. Now the important thing is to get rid of the cross line that marks the end and beginning of the texture. In this part, everyone does their own thing for each texture. Try to make it as natural as possible. Try to increase the count in the array modifier. It might help to get rid of the pattern a little. You are doing directly in Blender what you might be doing in GIMP or Photoshop. For the brick texture, I choose a difficult one to show that you can use this method on any texture you find. This method is wonderful for a quick fix or a texture that will appear in the background. It can be a time saver for sure. Don't forget to take a look at the original image, or make a backup, and save the new texture with Alt S, or in the menu above, Image, Save. As you can see, I got a bad brick texture. The top and bottom don't zigzag, but there are brick patterns like that in real places by design. I could cut the original texture, but I left the original image to show you how to add new creases, and use the strength of the brush to mix brick colors and correct differences between them in the collision of the new creases you are making. I bet you will create wonderful seamless textures. You know, I'm something of a texture creator myself. Ha ha ha. An extra step that I'll show you here is to see if our new texture looks good with a bump. For that, we add a color ramp and the bump node. Connect the image texture to the color ramp and connect it to the bump height. Depending on your texture, you can experiment with color ramp colors, where white represents a high surface and black, a deep surface. I added a lamp point to test the bump, and decrease the world shader's light strength. After a few tweaks, I added one more color ramp to specular, where black has no highlights and white does, depending on how roughness is. Every single texture will need extra attention to get the way you want it. Until next time, and sorry for the AI voice.